It's Sydney's new morning rush, not to get to work, just to get tested.
I've been in here an hour and I've got another 2 hours to go.
We started queuing up when it was still closed.
And this is the third place I've been to today I've been turned away.
The government says the system is under enormous pressure, laying blame squarely with the state still requiring travellers to get tested.
I'm, just as many people are in New South Wales, exhausted and had it with some of the actions that have been taken by the Queensland Premier. But at this point, I would rather work constructively and encouraging her today to just think about it.
But Queensland says it won't think about it until the new year. It has, however, dropped its day five testing requirement.
Data that we have received just in the last 24 hours can show that we are only seeing about a 0.6% positive cases coming from those day five tests.
New South Wales not alone in calling for relief. The tourism sector now reporting mass cancellations.
There's no doubt that the difficulties associated with testing at the moment mean that for many people it just looks too hard, and it is creating a level of reluctance to travel.
Ultimately bearing the brunt of that, tourism operators in Queensland.
We've certainly seen cancellations in the order of hundreds a day, and we saw people booking four-day holidays instead of week holidays or two-week holidays, so they didn't have to do that test. So it is really a big step forward that they announced today they're dropping that.
The federal government today urging all states to allow rapid antigen tests instead.
They're cheaper, they're faster than the PCR tests, and they can prevent the system being overloaded and prevent some of those long queues.
That unprecedented pressure today blamed for two major blunders at St Vincent's Hospital. Its pathology service confirming another 486 people were wrongly sent negative results when they were actually positive, saying a sizeable portion of SIDPATH's recent testing has involved those requiring a test for travel purposes. In order to maintain the quality of our testing, we are reducing the number of COVID tests we process. As the push towards rapid antigen tests gains pace, the Premier today confirmed New South Wales has ordered 20 million of them to be made freely available to the public.
My expectation is that they will be available by the end of January. These tests will be used for people going to high-risk settings, potentially going to hospitals, visiting elderly relatives, going clubbing.
As cases rise, so do hospitalisations. But in New South Wales, 2,000 health staff are now out of action after being exposed to the virus, the strain on the workforce prompting the government to slash their isolation periods.
People want to be able to do their job, and when people are being isolated, the shortfall of staff is putting pressure on those who are left to be able to do the job.
Roughly half the staff currently furloughed should now be able to return to work immediately. Claudia Farhart, SBS World News.